The Parliamentary Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs, which convened today to receive the 2022-2023 budget framework paper of the Minister of Defence, turned chaotic after the substantive minister, Vincent Sempijja, and Chief of Defence Forces General Wilson Imbadi, together with his deputy Lieutenant General Peter Elweru, shunned the meeting.
That the ruling you made and this committee made was without the input of the agency that appeared before you.
But you responded.
That we did not respond. Our response is here, not read.
But once you look at their representation, look at it. The minister himself was absent. He wasn't here. Maybe can be excusable. The chief of defense forces was not here. The deputy chief of defense forces was not here. The service chiefs are not here. And yet the only way parliament can hold any entity to account is the pass, the money, the budget. But once they come and present in a Kwara Kwara style and hope parliament will be too lenient and magnanimous, we thought that was a mistake on their part.
The delegation, which was led by the Minister of State for Defence, Jacob Oboth-Oboth, and that of Joint Chief of Staff, Major General Eric Chanda, failed to convince the heated-up MPs or even questioned the scope of their presentation, saying it was short of information about the UPDF budget performance.
The reason is that they looked at the documents we have brought and they said it was too small, without reading, without allowing us to read, to go through. This is the first time a parliamentary committee would go against the rules and decide to dismiss us without being heard. And they are the ones who set 9 issues for us to respond to. And the 9 issues we brought, they said we should write other things which they did not ask us. They have the document. This is not a ministerial policy statement. This is a budget framework paper, which they have copies. So we are responding to the clarification that they gave.
Like you're saying, actually you are raising tensions for nothing and emotions for nothing. And we are on the same page. What we are saying is this committee is your ally and a very good ally.
The meeting hit a stalemate before the chairperson Rosemary Nyachikongoro cut it short and sent back defense officials to reorganize their submission and return on Monday.
Their concern is about who did not come. So they were like on specific people who did not come. And whereas in the Ministry of Defense, our permanent secretary is not the accounting officer. The accounting officer is the person who was here. This is about money. The Joint Chief of Staff is the one concerned about the running, the day-to-day running of the businesses of the forces in the UPDF. There is a CDF who delegated him. So it's just, I think in their wisdom, they thought we should not be heard.
In their budget, UPDF seeks 89.7 billion shillings to support Operation Suja in Democratic Republic of Congo.
Exactly, that is one of the reasons I want them to know. Now you want the money. Has Parliament ever approved your operations in Congo? If we have never approved their operation, there is no way we can approve an illegality. There is no way.
Although the deployment in Congo had been planned the last 6 months, UPDF is seeking funding for 12 months.
It is around 89 billion for the 12 months. So more than 89 billion for the 12 months, but we are saying, how can we approve an illegality? That's not withstanding. I'm waiting for them on Monday.
Whereas the Minister of Defense submitted a budget requirement of 6.7 trillion for financial year 2022-2023, only 3.35 trillion has been allocated, leaving a funding gap of 3.38 trillion shillings. Story by Fred Kajui for the news.